Good morning, my lovely students. You are all welcome to today's class. My name is Mrs. Ayewole Alaba Adepeju. I'm glad to be here, and I believe you are all happy to see me from your various homes. Our first topic for this term is Thermal Energy 1. Thermal Energy 1. Under the subtopic, heat flow. But before we proceed, we'd like to see the objectives of today's class, which are: one, you must be able to define thermal energy, that is the meaning of thermal energy. You must be able to explain the process of heat transfer. And lastly, you are expected to be able to name the method of heat transfer. Firstly, what is thermal energy? Thermal energy is the energy that is generated and measured by heat. It is the kinetic energy of an atom, which is due to motion of particles. The addition of ice to a glass of water causes the temperature of the water to decrease because the thermal energy in the water causes the ice to melt. This one we can carry out, is a simple experiment we can carry out in our various homes. Other examples of thermal energy include the warmth we feel from the sun, when we are walking in the sun, how we feel the heat. Second example is a cup of hot chocolate drink. You want to have tea in the morning, the feeling you have when you are taking the drink. Also, in baking oven, when we are baking in our ovens at home, is an example of thermal energy. And lastly, the heat with which we feel from an heater. From my diagram here, you will see that thermal energy is the total of all kinetic and potential energy of the atoms in an object. When the thermal energy of a substance increases, its particle moves faster, like in boiling water. It is also a change in thermal energy which can lead to a change in phase. When it is applied through burner to a pot, the liquid would turn to gas, that is, it's a change of state when heat is applied. What is heat energy itself? Heat energy is the type of energy an object has because of the movement of its molecule. And heat energy can be transferred from one object to another. For example, a stove burner converts electrical energy to heat and conducts that energy through the pot to the water. The increase in the kinetic energy of the pot then makes the molecule to move faster and faster. Once it reaches the boiling point of the liquid, which is 100 degrees Celsius, the liquid will escape as vapor. The primary source of heat energy on Earth is the sun, and heat can be transferred through three means: conduction, convection, and radiation. The subheading of today's lesson is heat flow. Heat flow occurs when two objects of different temperature are brought together into contact with one another, thereby causing heat energy to flow from the hotter object to the colder object. An example is an object like iron rod through a medium. The two objects will exchange heat energy until their temperature become equal. Let me take this again. There's a fire burning and you introduce an iron rod into it. Before you know it, you will not be able to hold that iron rod again. You will drop it because it has been transferred to the iron rod. And at a point, the temperature of the two objects becomes equal. The state at which the temperature of these two objects become equal is called the state of thermal equilibrium. I take that again. The state at which the temperature of both objects becomes equal is called the state of thermal equilibrium. The unit of measuring heat is in joules. That is, heat can be measured in joules. This is a graphical representation of how heat is flow from a region of hot objects to a region of cooler objects. And at a point in time, the temperature of the two objects becomes equal. With this, we have come to the end of today's learning. There's a comprehensive note on the school website. Please endeavor to download it, copy the note, and do the assignments that follow. You can also read the recommended text for more explanation on this topic using our Basic Science for Junior Secondary School Book 2 by G.O. Omotiyole. Thank you and stay blessed. You are welcome once again to the second teaching of this week, that is the second topic for the term, which is thermal energy 1, heat transfer. The first one we did is thermal energy 1, which is how heat is flowed from one medium to another. But today we shall be seeing, or we are going to be talking about, how heat is being transferred from a region to another. But before I move ahead, please let's see the lesson objectives for today's class. The lesson objective for today's class are as follows. You all must be able to define heat transfer. You should be able to name the method of heat transfer. Also, I expect you to be able to describe heat condition and its application. You should be able to describe heat convention and its application. And lastly, you should be able to explain heat radiation and its application. Let's move ahead. What is heat transfer? Heat transfer is an aspect of thermal engineering that deals with the generation, use, conversion, and exchange of thermal energy. Heat transfer is also a process of transferring heat from a higher temperature reservoir to a lower temperature reservoir. It can flow or be transferred in three different ways: conduction, convection, and radiation. What is conduction? Conduction is a flow of heat by direct contact. It is the process by which heat energy is transferred from a region of higher temperature of a body to a lower temperature body along a stationary solid material. It is this process that makes pot on fire to transfer heat to the handle of the pot, even if only the tip of it is in the fire plate, especially in a metal. Let me explain that. We are at home, we want to boil a cup of tea. Once you put the kettle on the fire, it will be transferred through the burner to the pot. And in carrying it, the handle will have become heat because it has been transferred from the burner to all parts of the kettle. That is why it is advised that most of our cooking utensils should not be made of metals, especially the handle. What are metals? Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Examples include aluminium, copper, and iron. While wood, plastic, etc. are bad or poor conductors of heat and electricity. The handles of our saucepan, electric kettle, pots, and so on are made of poor conductors, so they can be easily carried when heated. Also, most of our electrical conductors are covered by insulators, so they do not conduct electricity. Examples are plastic, rubbers, glass, and many more. The application of conduction can be seen when you want to iron your school uniform. The heat from the iron will be transferred to your clothes, that is your school uniform, and make it to be smooth and it will look elegantly on you. Also, a metal spoon becomes hot from boiling water in a pot. If you have a pot of hot water and you drop a metal spoon inside, before you know it, the metal spoon is going to be very hot because it has been transferred to it from the hot pot of water. Convection is another way in which heat can be transferred. What is convection? Convection is a method of heat transfer that occurs only in liquid and gas, in which the hotter material moves into a cooler area. This can be seen in boiling water when the heat passes from the burner into the pot, heating the water at the bottom. It can also be seen in ice melting when heat moves to the ice from the wall, from the air, which causes the melting from solid to gas. Let me give you a typical example. You have a cup of ice cream or ice block. Once you bring it out from the freezer and place it on the table, in a matter of minutes, you see that the solid, which is the ice, will be melting to liquid. That's a form of convection. The application of convention can be seen in cooling of our homes, offices, car, and interior using the air conditioner. I'm in my class, I'm feeling hot, I discover that the temperature of the room is humid. I'll just go to the switch, put on the AC, and before you know it, convention will take place because the room will become cooler. Thirdly, is what is known as radiation. What is radiation? Radiation is a form of heat energy that comes from a source and travels through a space which may be able to penetrate into various materials. This is how energy from the sun reaches us here on Earth. That is why we feel heat when the sun, in the sun, wherever we are. Radiation is the action or process of radiating. The application of radiation can be seen in cooking, in the using the microwave, and communicating with our mobile phone. I have my mobile phone and somebody called me. Once I placed my mobile phone to my head to listen to my conversation, in minutes, about 5-10 minutes, the phone will become hot. So sometimes that I will even remove the phone from my head and put it on the speaker because the heat that is radiating is too much. That is a good example of radiation, which is one of the forms in which heat can be transferred from one medium to another. From my picture, you will see the three types of heat transfer. The first one is conduction, convection, and lastly is radiation, where heat is given out. With this, my lovely students, we have come to the end of today's class. I hope you have enjoyed, you enjoy the lesson, and I want to say that I want to see you next class. But before I move ahead, please endeavor to read your notes, go to the school website, download the comprehensive lesson notes on this topic, and also read your recommended text, Basic Science for Junior Secondary School Book 2 by Jiwo Omotsuyole. There are assignments that follow. Answer those assignments and submit via school website. Thank you and stay blessed.